हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू फाइनेंस एमसीक्यू। आई एम सीए प्रीतम सांगवान एंड फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट एमसीक्यूज रिगार्डिंग कंपनीज अमेंडमेंट एक्ट 2020, विच इज अ वेरी मच रिलेवेंट फॉर योर सेबी ग्रेड ए एग्जाम जर्नल स्ट्रीम। सो डू वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड एंड लेट्स बिगिन। क्वेश्चन 21, इन केस ऑफ अ लिस्टेड कंपनी, इफ एनी ऑडिटर, कॉस्ट ऑडिटर और सेक्रेटरियल ऑडिटर डज नॉट कंप्लाई विद द प्रोविजन ऑफ सेक्शन 143(12), दैट इज रिपोर्टिंग ऑफ फ्रॉड, ही शैल बी लाइबल फॉर अ पेनल्टी ऑफ ऑप्शन ए 1 lakh, देन 5 lakh और 10 lakh और 25 lakh। सो येस, वट विल बी द आंसर? द आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी, 5 lakh। फ्रेंड्स, थ्रू अमेंडमेंट फाइन इज रिड्यूस्ड फॉर नॉन रिपोर्टिंग ऑफ फ्रॉड फ्रॉम मिनिमम 1 lakh एंड मैक्सिमम 25 lakh टू अ फिक्स्ड अमाउंट ऑफ रुपीज 5 lakh, एंड इट इज फॉर ओनली लिस्टेड कंपनीज। सो इन केस ऑफ अ लिस्टेड कंपनी, ऑडिटर, कॉस्ट ऑडिटर, सेक्रेटरी ऑडिटर डज नॉट रिपोर्ट द फ्रॉड, देन ही विल बी लाइबल फॉर अ पेनल्टी ऑफ रुपीज 5 lakh। एंड वट विल हैपन इन केस ऑफ अ अनलिस्टेड कंपनी, सेम सिचुएशन, दैट ऑडिटर, कॉस्ट ऑडिटर, सेक्रेटरी ऑडिटर डज नॉट कंप्लाई विद द प्रोविजन एंड डज नॉट रिपोर्ट द फ्रॉड, then what will be the penalty for them? So yes, what will be the answer? The answer is option A, 1 lakh rupees. Friends, again here also from the amendment, they have changed this minimum and maximum concept to a fixed fine of rupees 1 lakh. So in case of a listed company, if auditor fails to report fraud, then the fine will be 5 lakh, and for unlisted company fails to report fraud, then there will be a fine of rupees 1 lakh fixed. There is no minimum and maximum. So I hope it is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Question 23, if company contravenes with the provisions of section 139 to section 146, then as per section 147, punishment for contravention, every officer in default shall be punishable with A, imprisonment up to 1 year, B, fine minimum 10,000, maximum 1 lakh, option C, either imprisonment or fine or both, or option D, no penal provision. So what they are asking, that if company contravenes provision of section 139 and 146, and in that they, if there is a no penal provision, then as per section 147, how much will be the penalty on those violation of those sections? So what is the answer? The answer is there will be a minimum fine of 10,000 and maximum of rupees 1 lakh. And friends, through this amendment, they have removed the imprisonment provisions, and there is no change in the fine on company or its officer. So I hope it is clear. Question number 24, whether an independent director can receive remuneration from the company excluding any fees payable under section 197(5), that is fees for your board meetings, etc. So whether the independent director can receive remuneration from the company, your options are option A, yes, option B, no, option C, yes, if company has no or inadequate profit, option D, yes, only if company has surplus profit. So yes, what's the correct answer? The answer is option C, yes, if company has no or inadequate profit. Friends, through this amendment, a proviso has been inserted under section 149(9), under which an independent director can take remuneration in case company has no or inadequate profit. So do remember this point. It is very important question and can be asked in your exam, that independent director can take remuneration from the company if company has no or inadequate profit. So I hope it is clear. Question number 25. If a person accepts an appointment as a director in violation of section 165(5), that is number of directorship, he shall be liable for a penalty of, so option A, rupees 50,000, option B, 5,000 per day for defaulting period subject to maximum 5 lakh, or option C, 2,000 per day for defaulting period subject to maximum 2 lakh, or D, no penal provision. So yes, what's the correct answer? The answer is option C, that is 2,000 per day for defaulting period subject to maximum of rupees 2 lakh. Friends, a person can hold 20 directorship, out of which maximum 10 in listed companies. Earlier, punishment for contravention of this section was rupees 5,000 per day during which such contravention continue. So through this amendment, they reduced from 5,000 to 2,000. subject to maximum of rupees 2 lakh. So I hope it is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Question 26. If a person continues to function as a director even after office of director become vacant, under section 167, vacation of director, he shall be punishable with A. imprisonment up to 1 year, B. fine minimum 1 lakh, maximum 5 lakhs, option C. either imprisonment or fine or both, D. no penal provision. So yes, what's the correct answer? The answer is option. There will be a minimum fine of 1 lakh, maximum can be 5 lakh rupees. Friends, through this amendment, they have reduced the imprisonment provision and there is no change in the fine. So friends, if you understanding this amendment, they have removed all the imprisonment related provisions from the sections. So I hope it is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Question 27. In case of violation of section 149 to section 171, where no such penalty is mentioned, then company and every officer in default will be punishable with A. penalty of rupees 50,000, B. penalty of rupees 1 lakh, C. continued failure rupees 500 per day, subject to maximum for company 3 lakh and for officer in default 1 lakh. Or option D, that is either penalty of 50,000 and continued failure penalty, or option E, that is penalty of 1 lakh and continued failure penalty for company and officer. So yes, what's the correct answer? The correct answer is option D, that is penalty and per day fine subject to maximum limit, penalty of rupees 50,000. Friends, through this amendment, per day fine for continued failure for defaulting period was added. If there is a violation of section 149 to 179, then company and every officer in default will be liable for penalty of 50 and for continued failure rupees 500 per day, subject to maximum on company rupees 3 lakh and for officer rupees 1 lakh. So I hope it is clear. Question number 28. If company violates the provisions of section 178, that is nomination and remuneration committee and stakeholders relationship committee, or of section 177, that is audit committee, then penalty on company and officer in default is A. company minimum fine 1 lakh, maximum 5, and on officer rupee minimum 25, maximum 1 lakh, and also imprisonment, which may be extended to up to 1 year, or both imprisonment and fine. Or option B, for company rupees 3 lakh and on officer rupees 50,000, or option C, on company 5 lakh and on officer rupees 1 lakh, or D, no penal provision. So yes, what's the correct answer? The correct answer is option C, that is on company there will be a fine of rupees 5 lakh and on officer in default rupees 1 lakh rupees. Friends, through this amendment, they have fixed the fine. That is, they remove this minimum and maximum fine concept. They just fix the fine that in case of a violation of this section, then on company 5 lakh fine and on officer rupees 1 lakh. And they also remove the imprisonment provisions from the section. So I hope it is clear. Question 29. In case of a violation of provision section 184.1 and 184.2 relating to disclosure of interest by directors, he shall be punishable with A. imprisonment, B. fine of 1 lakh, or C. imprisonment and fine, or D. no penal provision. So yes, the answer is, that is option B, fine of rupees 1 lakh. Friends, through this amendment, penal provision of imprisonment is removed and they have fixed the penalty of fine of rupees 1 lakh. Earlier, they have imprisonment and fine may extend to up to 1 year. So they have removed this thing and they have just fixed the penalty amount, that is of rupees 1 lakh. So I hope it is clear. Question 30. If company contravenes with the provisions of section 187, that is investments of company to be held in its own name, then company and every officer in default shall be punishable with option A, for company fine of 25, minimum maximum 25 lakh, and for officer minimum 25, maximum 1 lakh, along with that imprisonment maximum up to 1 year or both, or option B, company rupees 5 lakh fine and officer rupees 1 lakh fine, option C, on company rupees 5 lakh fine and officer on officer rupees 50,000, और डी नो पिनल प्रोविजन। सो यस, व्हाट्स द करेक्ट आंसर? द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, दैट इज फाइन विल ऑन कंपनी रुपीज 5 लाख एंड ऑफिसर इन डिफॉल्ट रुपीज 50,000 विल बी फाइन। फ्रेंड्स, इफ कंपनी होल्ड्स इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इन द नेम ऑफ इट्स मेंबर, डॉक्टर्स एक्सेट्रा, देन बोथ कंपनी एंड ओडी विल बी लाइबल फॉर अ फिक्स्ड फाइन। प्रायर टू दिस अमेंडमेंट, ऑफिसर इन डिफॉल्ट वॉज ऑल्सो लाइबल फॉर इम्प्रिजनमेंट, सो दे रिमूव दिस इम्प्रिजनमेंट कॉन्सेप्ट एंड ऑल्सो रिमूव दिस मिनिमम एंड मैक्सिमम फाइन। सो नाउ दे हैव जस्ट फिक्स्ड द फाइन, दैट इज 5 लाख एंड 50,000। सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर। नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 31। In case of a violation of provision of section 188, that is related party transaction, then a director or employee of a listed company shall be liable for a penalty of A 1 lakh or 5 lakh or 10 lakh or 25 lakh. So yes, what will be the penalty? The answer is option D, 25 lakh. Friends, through amendment, amount of fine is fixed. Earlier, minimum and maximum fine limit was prescribed. So now, if there is a violation of section 188, of a listed company, then director or employee will be liable. And now what will happen in case of an unlisted company? So that is in the next question. So here, if violation of section 188 other than a listed company, then what will be the penalty on director and employee? Option A, 1 lakh or 5 lakh, 10 lakh or 25 lakh. So yes, what's the correct answer? The answer is 5 lakh. Friends, here also they have fixed the fine amount and they have removed the minimum and maximum limit criteria. So do try to remember that for listed company, if violation of section 188 is related party transaction, they have considered serious offense and the penalty is 25 lakh rupees. And in case of other than listed company, here you have unlisted company, private company or any other company, then the fine is will be rupees 5 lakh for violation of section 188 related party transactions. So I hope it is clear. Question 33. In case of a violation of provision of section 204, that is secretarial audit for bigger companies, then a director, officer of a company or company secretary who are at the default shall be liable for a penalty of option A, 1 lakh or 2 lakh or 3 lakh or 5 lakh. So yes, what's the answer? The correct answer is option C, 3 lakh rupees. Friends, through this amendment, amount of fine is fixed. So they have fixed the fine amount. Prior to that, there was a minimum of 1 lakh and maximum of 5 lakh rupees was prescribed. So they removed this minimum maximum concept. Now the fixed fine of 3 lakh in case of a violation of section 204. Question 34. Maximum number of members in an appellate tribunal, that is your NCLAT, National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, as constituted under section 410 of Companies Act is, what is the maximum members limit? A 6, B 11, C 15, D no limit. So yes, what's the correct answer? The answer is no limit. Friends, through this amendment, the limit on maximum number of members in NCLAT has been removed. Earlier it was prescribed as 11 member. Now there is a no limit on maximum number of members in NCLAT. Question 35. Section 418A of Companies Act related to A, benches of the appellate tribunal, B, records of the company, C, scheme of arrangement, merger and demerger, option D, one person company. So yes, what's the correct answer? The correct answer is option A, benches of the appellate tribunal. Friends, this is the new section inserted through amendment under which powers of appellate tribunal may be exercised by the benches, that is the various benches in the country. Let's say suppose NCLAT is in New Delhi. So they may create a bench in other locations, say suppose Jaipur, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, etc. They create a bench subject to it consists of at least one judicial member and one technical member, which may be constituted by the chairperson. So I hope this section is also clear, that for 18 relates to the benches of appellate tribunal. So friends, with this I try to cover all the important and relevant MCQ questions related to your company's amendment act 2020, and some questions can be asked from this amendment also, so do prepare them. Friends, if you want to prepare more such kind of MCQ questions, please visit financemcq.in, There we have entire SEBI Grade A exam technical syllabus, that is your paper 2 of a journal stream for both phase 1 and phase 2 is in MCQ format. There we have 2000 plus subject wise, topic wise MCQ questions to practice, and we have added explanations for correct answers wherever required. Further, we have 25 test series of your paper 2 to practice. So there are lot of content to practice. So do visit on Finance MCQ website. You still have some time for your exam, that is on your 17th January. So just go and visit and prepare for your paper 2 and try to solve as many as MCQ as you can. So thank you so much for watching. Take care.